Welcome to Tips for Economics and Business in High School. This podcast belongs to a collection hosted at tebhs.blogspot.com. Today we will continue with the elasticity. Once we know what elasticity is, now the question would be, why is it important? Well, let's imagine that you have a small business where you sell one single product. The total revenue of your business is calculated price times quantity. Now, if you had sold last term 1,000 units at $10 each, your total revenue must have been $10 times 1,000 units, $10,000. Not bad, but what if you could know about the price elasticity of demand that your product has? If you manage to find out that your product has, for instance, an elastic demand, you will benefit from price reductions. Let's have a quick reminder from our last podcast. A proportional reduction in the price will get a more than proportional increase in the amount demanded. It means that if you reduce the price, you will get more sales that will compensate the lower price per unit. For instance, let's reduce the price 10%. Thanks to the fact that our product has an elastic demand, we know that the sales will increase over 10%, let's say 15%. From the last term with a price of $10 per unit and 1,000 units sold, we would go next term having a price of $9 and 1,150 units sold. What will happen to the total revenue then? Let's do the math. Our last term we got $10,000. Next term it would be $10,350. So we got more. And that is why elasticity is so important in business. If your product has an elastic demand, you will benefit from price reductions. But if it has an inelastic demand, you could benefit from price increases. Want to know more? Leave an opinion? Please feel free to do so and stay tuned for more tips. And thanks for watching.